All right, first set of numbers. I'm gonna say, well, I'm not gonna give the each one of them. I'm missing an idea. That's not straight, but forgive me.
Is that a new one?
This is, what's that?
Is that a different one?
This is a different one. If you would've listened to me, you would've probably seen what you, I made a noise when I wrote one of the numbers. Okay. It's a wash. This is not really an accurate test.
Mm-hmm.
Good pun.
Huh? It's a good pun.
Pun?
Yeah. It's a wash.
It's a wash. So, anyway, you guys see that? Mm-hmm. Okay, if we didn't have the ionized water in there, what would we be doing for the pH?
Lactate.
Yeah, calcium lactate. Even calcium citrate could be added with the calcium lactate rather than a gluconate, and we would focus more on those two for a while. Six capsules of the lactate, depending on, I don't use citrate, so, but that's one you would use here. What about vitamin C?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you could use vitamin C, you could use 2, 3, 4 grams, and that would be pretty safe. All right, can we move on that? Mm-hmm. So we didn't get a really good picture on here. We didn't really address this. This is a bit high, but because she's probably been on a bit of a health program here, this is probably a little bit of a dumping that's going on there. All right, what about our friend here that's 72, 5'10", 160 pounds? Well, he's not overly skinny, but he's a little bit on the thinner side. What do you see there? Heart trouble from...
Ooh, the 40 will get you.
Yeah. What is the most troubling thing?
The sediment. Second is waste. Mm-hmm.
So even though we have a low pH here, we have high ureas, we have really high salt, we have high sugar, and this is one of those things where, you know, we always talk about the debris being one of those things that, for the most part, is relatively unimportant when we're starting to work with somebody. But in this case, this person's debris is probably the worst thing in his test. Well, it's not probably. It is the worst thing in his test. This is a sign that this person is shutting down. Now, that does not mean that he's hopeless or anything. For him to recover will be a bit more difficult because of his age. You see that? His reserve energy is also becoming a factor in this. You know, his sugar's high, but it's not. It would be worse. Hey, what would be some scenarios that would make this guy's situation worse? Like if you looked at this, this guy's still, even though this is a pretty bad deal right here, what would make this guy's situation even more hopeless?
If his sugar was lower, he would be feeling worse.
Yeah, if this guy's sugar was like even a 2 or a 1.5, that would be a really bad spot, okay? Because his situation is getting much more hopeless. What would be like an end stage number? Like, this guy probably is somebody that, you know...
That's what I want to know.
What would be like, as far as getting away from like a 1 here, what would be the ultimately the worst thing that we'd see?
6 to 7 feet.
No, that's a good sign, but...
That the ureas were...
Yeah, like what about a 0.3
right.
Or a 1.2,
yeah.
Something like that. That would be a pretty drastic thing. Mm-hmm. This guy's spot would be really serious, okay? Mm-hmm. He just doesn't have, he has a lot of energy going in, but nothing's coming out.
If you hit somebody like this, would you just send him to the hospital?
No.
If it was end stage?
Well, it just depends. Like, okay, I know... We figure out point of no return.
Yeah.
My point of no return basically is that they can't get up. Mm-hmm. I because the situation that we're in, like if Sue and I were working with people on a one-on-one basis, you know, there's only one guest at a time, two guests at a time. I would and I had good insurance and all of that. Mm-hmm. I would work with this person even if they were like bedridden. But you're going to be able to do far more good for more people if you can shuffle the person that's in a bad spot to somebody else that's equipped to deal with that. Because this is going to require an exponential amount of energy to deal with somebody that's in a situation. Like, I'm not talking about this guy here, this situation here, but like, let's say he was in this spot here and even compounded worse with a low spot here. I would shuffle him somewhere else. You know, it's important to try to figure out like your real capabilities and how much you could actually do. And the other thing is, you know, when you're dealing with people that are really sick, sometimes it becomes about like glory in the sense, oh, here's somebody who has advanced melanoma or leukemia or lymphoma, and what we want to do is get them back to health, you know, and I'm going to get the credit for this person getting well. Well, if this person dies because, you know, you didn't have the ability to actually take care of them the way you should, then...
That's not credit.
What's that?
That's not good credit.
No, and it's really a... You really shouldn't be in a position where you're helping people. You got to learn to know what your limits are. And I'm not saying... this person, from the background, I gathered that he's walking and talking and everything, and... This is actually okay, but this is the worst part in this guy's test, okay? Go ahead.
I was going to tell you the rest of the story. It's not over yet, but I do want to tell you that 10 days later, he was a 4M++.
See, there you go. Yeah.
And his urine was 6.1 and saliva 6.4.
Urine was 6.1, saliva 6.4?
Hey, that's... That is the melanoma guy. That's the melanoma guy. Mm-hmm.
And there were 4 different tests, but, you know, he seemed like he was heading in the right direction, but the total ureas was 21.
Getting a bit high.
Mm-hmm.
What would you do for that?
I don't know.
What did his sugar say?
His sugar was, well, adjusted 3.2, but it was a 5.
When it was a 21?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'll put him on a fast.
Well, that's what I was trying to do with him, you know, but he was uncooperative.
Okay. Is he diabetic?
No. Mm-mm, he's not diabetic. He was a really healthy guy.
Yeah, I'd put him on a fast if you could find some way to talk him into that.
Mm-hmm. For how long?
3 days.
Water? 3 days. Lemon water? Or?
Yeah, he could go on a lemon water fast. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's all right.
If he went on lemon water, could he use maple syrup or something, or would that not be good with the sugar?
Well, his sugars are a little bit on the high side.
Right.
When I had the hospital down there, every patient came in to be an intern patient. I put him on 3 days of fasting, 4 days of raw food, with animals every day and steam baths every day.
That's about what we do to people here too.
That's why they got well.
When would you not put somebody on a fast?
When the sugar number is low, that's when you're going to have the most trouble there.
Okay.
And the salt will feed into that too.
Both of them being low?
Yeah, but in that, I mean, the most critical in that, because you could add a little salt to the water or something.
Right, yeah.
But in that, the sugar level is the most thing. You don't want people sweating and passing out on it.
And what do you consider low for fasting sugar?
Well, depending on the salt number there again, like if this guy's salt number stayed at this level and he was a 3, 3.5, that would still be on the low end of putting them on a water fast. If it was like a 1.5 and a 1, you know, that's real low.
Would you give him enzymes for his urea?
Yeah, that would be a good thing right there. Mm-hmm. Do you ever use high doses of pancreatic enzymes?
Mm-hmm.
That would be something.
That'd be good.
Yeah, that would be something in this situation that would be really beneficial. Okay, what kind of calciums would we work with first in this guy?
Gold.
What's that?
Coral calcium.
Okay, that would be a good one.
Yeah. And he's on that. He got on that. That was one of the things he was taking.
Okay, coral calcium, Cal-2, vitamin D. Why not? You could do 50,000 units, 25,000 units would be a little bit more realistic, you know. I'm a little bit more quick just to throw 50,000 at people than maybe I should be, but I've never seen anybody get rid of that. I just try to get them out of the acid range, pump them up, even if it's up there in the 7, 7.2, 7.4 range. Then I'll begin to try to balance it out after I get that up.
Are you talking about 50,000 a day for a while?
Mm-hmm. Okay. A couple of weeks. Yeah, I mean, a month at 50,000 units. I mean, there's people like the pH miracle people. They'll give 50,000 units for months on end. So, yeah.
Would you say parasites might be an issue with the 2-point difference?
Okay, pH here is a bit low.
Uh-huh.
This right here is opposite. We're seeing much more heart stress.
Mm-hmm. When you say opposite, what do you mean?
Usually you see a higher nitrate.
Oh, okay.
Okay? Like if that was a 7.9, and that was even a 6.4.7, or a 7.7, you might see some parasite issues more common. That does not mean he does not have any parasites. That just means that it's less of a burden on him.
Mm-hmm.
You going to say something, Brother Dennis?
No, I was just trying to figure out. You say when the salt is high and the
ammonia number.
Ammonia number.
Those two are definite correlation with heart stress. Mm-hmm. And the other thing is the total number is also going to be playing into that.